Turn your ear, O Lord, and answer me. Send the servant who trusts in you, my God. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I cry to you all the day long. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, welcome to the Eucharistic celebration and a special welcome to our seminary students who are joining us live stream. It's kind of unfair that they can see us, but we cannot see them. Before celebrating the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins, asking the Lord for forgiveness and mercy. I confess,
O my God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done,
what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who caused the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world, our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We instruct you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to shun any brother who walks in a disorderly way, and not according to the tradition they received from us. For you know how one must imitate us. For we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we worked, so as not to be a burden on any of you. Not that we do not have the right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. May the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times and in every way. The Lord be with all of you. This greeting is in my own hand, Paul's. This is the sign in every letter. This is how I write. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Blessed are you who fear the Lord, who walk in his ways. For you shall eat the fruit of your handiwork. Blessed shall you be and favored.
Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
Behold, thus is the man blessed. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Whoever keeps the word of Christ, the love of God is truly perfected in him.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to the Lord.
Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You are like whitewashed tombs, which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous, but inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evildoing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the memorials of the righteous. And you say, if we had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood. Thus you bear witness against yourselves that you are the children of those who murdered the prophets. Now fill up what your ancestors measured out. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's Gospel, Jesus warned the Pharisees of their wrongdoings. Who were the Pharisees anyway? They were religious teachers in Jesus' time. They studied the Bible. They studied the Gospel and knew it very well. And they often dressed in fancy clothes to make themselves stand out among the people. They thought that following rules was more important than loving and being kind to others. They often show off by playing out loud in public. They were very prideful and they thought they were holier and better than anybody else. A Pharisee is like a fake friend. He may talk to you nicely, smiling with you, but behind you, he spreads gossip about you. In his heart, he does not truly love you. He may fake a smile, but he can never fake what is in his heart. So, in the Gospel, Jesus condemns the Pharisees for their deceitful lifestyle. He reminds us that true love comes from the heart. What is in the heart is more important than what's on the lips. We cannot just say, I love God, but do nothing about it. If I truly love God, I will obey Him, pray to Him. Just like because I love my parents, I will obey them and help them to do the housework. Sisters and brothers, and dear students of St. Anne's, Jesus knows what is in our hearts. We are true children of God if we love Him from the bottom of our heart. Amen. Let us pray. Trusting in the Lord who knows the intentions of our hearts, let us bring our prayers before Him. For all members of the Holy Church, may God give each of us a sincere and genuine heart to love and serve Him. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the leaders of our country and our world, may the Holy Spirit give them wisdom and compassion. We pray to the Lord. For parents, who are the first and foremost teachers of their children, that the Lord's wisdom and strength will continue to inspire them in their responsibilities. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our St. Anne's students, teachers, faculty, and staff, that we learn to love others as Christ has loved us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, especially our family members, that they will live forever in the everlasting peace of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Loving Father, we thank you for listening to our hearts
and ask that you answer our intentions according to your holy will, to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed
be
God forever.
Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. Praise the glorious name for God with the Church.
O Lord, who gave for yourself the people by adoption, to the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you love in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those deeds of yours that by sinning we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim,
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift we pray by sending down the Spirit upon them like a newfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith, we proclaim the death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. To him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the sailor's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy of thee, gentleness of the mind, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, says the Lord, and I will raise him up on the last day. together with our seminary students and all those who join us last week, we pray the spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael,
you are the angel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke you, we humbly pray. And you, thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking to live in the soul. Amen.
Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary, that we never know what to know. That anyone who led by thy protection, implored by thy help, sought thy intercession, was left unaided, inspired by his confidence and thy glory unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my mother, to thee do I come before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in thy mercy hear and answer me.
Our Lady of Palm Sutton,
patience to help us.
Our Lady of Palm Sutton,
patience to help us.
Our Lady of Palm Sutton,
patience to help us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.